know, she tells herself. Memories back when she was bold and strong and waiting for the world to come along. Swear she knew and now she swears she's gone. She lies and says she still loves him, can't find a better man. She dreams in color, she dreams in red, can't find a better man. She lies and says she still loves him, can't find a better man. No, she dreams in color, she dreams in red, can't find a better man. Can't find a better man. She loved him, yeah. She don't want to leave this way, yeah. She feeds him, That's why she'll be back again.
Gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of the War Panties Power Hour, coming at you weekly, every Tuesday evening. Ladies and gentlemen, all that Pat, I'm Phil the Thrill. How the hell are you, Pat?
I'm doing great. I did a little camping this weekend, got wet, got home, and got dry.
You know, a lot of people out there in internet land think camping is for the birds. They think you got electricity, you got shelter, you got running water. Why would you venture out into the wilderness? Well, who knows what's going to do who knows where to your who knows when?
Your neighbors frown on it when you start a campfire inside.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is safety tip number one from the War Panties Power Hour. Never start... What are they called?
Campfires.
Campfires indoors, or your neighbors will come at you. Ladies and gentlemen, last week, what a great episode. Our first holiday episode. It was the hippity-hoppity-happity Easter, ladies and gentlemen. Happy Easter episode. And you can check it out on all of the sources. And you know what I'm talking about by sources? I'm talking about the socials. Hold on. Let me get my calculator of Albatross, whatever it's called from the olden days, my 8-bit NES and my 4-bit Atari. I'm talking about the internet, ladies and gentlemen, the internet. The socials. We're on the Facebook. We're on the Instagram. We're on the YouTube. Check out our YouTube channel. We're trying to get 10 likes. Actually, we already have 10. We're trying to get 100, so ha.
Oh, that's a whole other digit.
We're also on Twitter. We're also on TikTok. We're also on Grindr. We're also on Hit Me Up Mama and BB Dubs.
Did you say Facebook?
We're also on Facebook.
Facebook.
Check us out on all the socials. And don't forget warpanties.com, which it does exist. We pay for it monthly. Believe it or not, it's there. It's horrible looking. If you ever really check it out. Have you ever looked at it?
No.
Okay.
But I will.
What we'd like to have right now is for all of you out there watching on internet land, get out your phone. Go to warpanties.com. Step one, first, marvel it actually is a functioning website.
Mm.
That name goes to a website. And then B, write down about 3, 4, 5 ways that you can make fun of us and ridicule us for how horrible the War Panties website is laid out. Step two.
Okay.
Step three. put it in the mail and mail it right to our undisclosed War Panties recording basement location here. And we will read the best mean, derogatory things said about the War Panties website.
So mail it to the undisclosed location.
We'll put it in the hate bucket. Speaking of mail, Pat, you want to jump right to the love mailbag? Last week we skipped the love.
We did get a nice piece of love mail from the past week. An anonymous writer actually wrote it. Let me find it.
Anonymous.
Oh, here it is right here.
That's never good.
Well, it says right here they're still alive. Phil the Thrill at War Panties.
Oh, it's addressed to me. That's me, Phil the
Address
Thrill.
Redacted.
Is there a return address?
No, there was no return address.
Wait, let me see that. Uh-oh. You know what this means. Pat, you know what this usually means.
They don't want to hear back from us. That's what that means.
No, damn it, Pat. Usually when we get an anonymous mail, it's from, you guessed it, the reptilian overlords that run War Panties Corp!
Oh.
So, whenever we get anonymous mail, the first thing that we do is we always try to get to the bottom of who actually sent the parcel, or the letter, or the parchment, whatever it is. Because the reptilian overlords, like we said, they're scary, they run War Panties Corp, they pay our bills, so we love them.
You remember that very threatening Christmas card they sent us?
Pat, don't talk about that Christmas card anymore. So we get to the bottom of this by first, we've sent this letter to our expert War Panties penmanship and handwriting analysis team. So that's in process. Oh, yeah. Show them that letter there.
Yeah.
If anyone knows anyone with this handwriting, you see that, everyone? If this handwriting looks familiar to anybody, please reach out. Call a neighbor. Call the local authorities. And call us here at the War Panties Undisclosed Basement Recording Location. Second thing we did after the handwriting analysis was we dusted it for prints. And what we found, which might be a clue, because we did find a rare pollen sample native to islands off the coast of Central America. So what we're doing in the database is we're cross-referencing...
Central America? It doesn't smell like cocaine.
Pat! So what we're doing is we're cross-referencing... everyone who is in Central America against the War Panties fandom, of which there are literally dozens and dozens of people. So anyone in that dozens and dozens of fans who are also from Central America, we're on to you.
And we know what your writing looks like.
Mm-hmm. So with that said, we are well on our way to discovering and solving the mystery of the anonymous War Panties fan mail. But hey, Pat, why don't we just go ahead and read it and, you know, let's have some faith, indulge. What does that have to say?
Well, this really isn't hate mail or love mail. It's just kind of really short and to the point. Dear War Panties, please play some Pearl Jam. Thanks. Signed, Jeremy.
Another clue. Pat?
Yes.
Do you think the writer of this letter might have signed it Jeremy as an alias that doesn't reflect their real name?
I think we'll let the analysis do the work for us.
I think in the end the data will speak for itself.
We'll find you. We'll find you, Jeremy.
Anyway, you know what? We do appreciate that anonymous piece of mail, and we will play Pearl Jam, but it must be someone that knows me because Pearl Jam is Phil the Thrill's favorite band. Definitely from childhood and probably still now. So we thought today on the War Panties Power Hour, before we play a song for you, we would tell you a little bit about our favorite bands. Growing up, our bands that really got us into the music thing and what got our blood pumping, our heart throbbing, and our, you know, emotions going through the roof.
When I was a child, I was really into movies. And seeing David Bowie in Labyrinth was a big influence. That really took me, like this is something that I have to do. Grow my hair out, wear some tights, spin the little balls in my hand, and then, dance around with some Muppets. And that just made it seem out of this world. I was like, how do I get to be David Bowie with the Muppets? And to me, that was all downhill from there.
The other music, what about the, I guess you were too young for the Beatles movies, right?
Oh, yeah, I like the Beatles. I grew up on the Beatles. The only thing better than the Beatles would be Weird Al Yankovic.
Oh! Yeah. See, I knew about the Weird Al thing.
Yeah.
Pat is in the Weird Al Touring Caravan Club for the Weird Al fans out there.
This is true. Yeah. Weird Al has some wild backstage parties there.
When did you get into Weird Al? Was that as a young man or older?
Oh, no, I was a small child.
A small child.
I was a small child when Eat It came out. I was like, this is the best song ever. Listen to that guitar solo. And then some other dude came out with a song, sounded just like it. And I figured... And it just wasn't the same. I was like, you can't copy Weird Al. You know?
Yeah.
What are your favorite bands growing up, Phil?
As a child of the 90s, totally into Pearl Jam. They were my number one. But then, just like you, the videos is what pulled me in. But it wasn't the movie videos. It was the music videos on, that was kind of the prime of MTV, the heyday of MTV.
Oh,
the
yeah.
The early 90s with those awesome high production videos.
Well, the prime of MTV was in the early to mid 80s, my friend.
See, we're going to have to, this will be a topic for another War Panties Power Hour. But in the early 90s, that's when it was major like motion picture budget on this stuff. I remember the Michael Jackson Black or White video. That blew my mind. That was the cutting edge of technology right there.
Mm.
I think that's the guy that ripped off Eat It.
I didn't have cable.
I did. Yeah, the Jeremy video, the Teen Spirit video, obviously. All the Green Day videos, Smashing Pumpkins. And then even Alanis Morissette. See, that's the love baby. I always wanted Eddie Vedder and Alanis Morissette to get married.
I didn't even know those bands made videos.
Alanis Morissette?
Yeah.
Jagged Little Pill. Everyone had that, dude.
Man, nope.
Whereas my childhood music ruined your childhood music?
Yes.
What ruined my childhood music, if you want to know Phil the Thrills version of rock and roll history, was the summer of 1997 when five British women came across the pond and sang, "If You Want to Be My Lover," and my little sister hung up the posters in my room, and that was it. At the young age of 13, I had cut off any appreciation for anything new. I had already seen it all, done it all. That was it.
She hung up posters in your room?
And her room.
And her room.
It was everywhere. It was a tea party nightmare.
Well, as a young man, I'm sure you like to look at pictures of the Spice Girls.
And I was 13.
Yeah. Well.
I found my uses for those posters. Anyway, of course, after that, we had the Britney Spears and the Christina Aguileras and the Backstreet Boys and the NSYNCs and the 98s. And, well, it was just all over then. Just hand me the gun, why don't you?
Yeah.
Put it in my temple and pull the trigger. So, without further ado.
Yeah, there's other things other than pop music that you can enjoy.
Right. Well, at that point, Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Rock were rising from the ashes out of the Bret Hitman Hart and Shawn Michaels era.
And
I could finally be proud to be a wrestling fan. Hmm. Which I was all through the New Generation era. Ladies and gentlemen, please leave your comments on the New Generation era right down here in our Facebook comments section, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Pat, you want to play a Pearl Jam song for all these fine people in the anonymous love fan letter?
Well, they asked for it. This is for Jeremy, anonymous Jeremy, who was kind enough to send us a letter in our undisclosed location.
And we're trusting that you're not a reptilian overlord. All right, Pat, let's play one for him.
Let's do it.
Reeling is what they say, or is it just my way? Wind blows by, low light, sidetrack. Tell me wrong, All I feel is calm. Voice blows by, low light. Car crash, low light. Can't wear my mask. Your first, my goes by. Two birds is what they'll see, getting lost upon their way. Voice blows by, low light. Eyesight, I need the light. I'll find my way from harm. What's real? This dream I see.
Acoustic fade out.
Fade out.
Fade out.
In person fade out.
Shh. I always loved Eddie Vedder and Bret the Hitman Hart. So I try to be a combination of those two.
You're like their baby. Yeah, I see that. Totally.
You do?
Yes.
I'm the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be, eh? That's Canadian.
Eh?
So what was I saying? This is a lot of crap I'm going to have to sift through.
Yeah, it is. Cut.